How's it going, guys? Sam bringing you a Pokemon X and Pokemon Y Wi-Fi battle against Justabomb, a pretty popular YouTuber, so his link will be in the description. Go check him out. He's got some cool stuff on his channel and whatnot. So, take a look at the teams real quick. I'm doing this team review pretty quickly, actually. And yeah, I'm bringing the standard Stew team, the standard stuff you've all seen before. So we'll just go over Justabomb's team. From himself, Talonflame, Greninja, Sylveon, Hawlucha, Goodra, and Smeargle. And, the main thing that really threatened me was obviously Talonflame. I do have Donphan, which does take on Talonflame pretty well, but could have been worrying. Hawlucha, I don't see too much of, so I was kind of afraid of that thing as well. And Goodra, just because if I lose Mamoswine, I could have a tough time taking that thing out. So, let's just get into the battle and see how it went. Alright, so Justabomb's gonna lead off with the Smeargle, as I do lead off with my Breloom, and that's a very good matchup for me. And knowing that he probably carries the Focus Sash, I am gonna go straight for the Bullet Seed, and judging by the damage, as you're gonna see, it is a solid 2-hit KO, so definitely good play on my part to go for the Bullet Seed, breaking the Sash, as it would not actually count on Bullet Seed, and take out a Smeargle, which could have been used to set up Hazards and stuff, so I've already stopped that on the first turn, which is great. So he goes out into his Talonflame, goes for the Brave Bird. I know I have the Focus Sash, so I know I'm going to be able to live with 1 HP. And I'm going to take that opportunity to go for the Spore on the Talonflame, putting that pretty threatening Pokemon to sleep, really. It does face off against my team really well. So put that thing to sleep, and I just sort of neutralize the threat for the time being, as I believe I am going to switch out now into my Donphan, knowing that if he wakes up on the first turn, I've had pretty bad Spore luck with sleep turns. So if he does manage to wake up on the first turn, then I can at least tank a hit with Donphan. So he stays asleep, which is great. He stays asleep on the next turn too, which is also very good. But go for the Stone Edge. Do in fact miss. Obviously that sucks. As he's gonna wake up, it would have definitely killed because it is 4x effective, and Talonflame, from past experience, does not appreciate a 4x super effective move, especially not Stone Edge. So he goes for Brave Bird, doesn't do that much. Go for Stone Edge again. I miss. This Talonflame should not have been that much of a problem to hit, but it does allow him to switch out, knowing that I do pack the Stone Edge, even though I don't know why he stayed in the first place, but that was his choice. And now he switches out into his Greninja. Finally do hit the Stone Edge. This does very, very respectable damage. And yeah, I'm very happy with that from Donphan. So he missed two, which would have obviously taken out the Talonflame, but does a solid 50% to the Greninja, so I'm definitely not disappointed by any means. Go now to my Goodra, just in case he wants to go for any special attack, goes for the Hydro Pump. And, I just take this so well. I mean, yeah, that was nothing. That was literally nothing. That was like 19 HP from a Hydro Pump. But I'm gonna switch out. I think I predicted him to switch out into something else. So we got into my Mamoswine as he goes for the Night Slash. Luckily, he didn't go for like Hydro Pump again or anything. But yeah, I was kind of worrying because I didn't actually expect him to stay in. I honestly thought he would switch into something else. So I went to Mamoswine knowing I could probably take it. I don't remember what I expected him to go to. Maybe Sylveon, actually. Yeah, predicting the Dragon-type move. So I went to Mamoswine knowing Mamoswine could take on Sylveon easily. I goes for a Night Slash after going for Hydro Pump, which again does not much damage. Night Slash does a lot more, so good to see some mixed set Greninja. I usually run a special expert belt, but seeing some mixed sets is cool as well. Go for a Thunderbolt, knock out the Greninja, as he now goes out into his Hawlucha, and I underestimated this thing a lot. I don't see it too often. Well, I haven't seen it often in the battles I've had so far, so I really underestimated this thing's speed and how fast it was. Go for a Thunderbolt anyway on the substitute, so luckily I did not switch and allow him to get a free sub, because this thing buying a free sub is definitely a problem. And I'm gonna force him to go for the Acrobatics on my Goodra and knock it out, but here's where I make the mistake. I am a modest Greninja, not timid, so I go out into it as he goes for the High Jump Kick, actually outspeeding me, which again caught me off guard. Maybe he is fully IV'd. I know my team here isn't. I'm working on IV'ing them, but they're not all IV'd yet. And yeah, maybe that's what paid the price, I guess, but gonna go to Mamoswine, or I am gonna go to Mamoswine, threaten him out because the Ice Shard from that range will kill, as he goes out into his Sylveon, which it's not a counter. It's not a counter to the Mamoswine. It's not definitely something you should switch in, because I do well, I do about half with an Ice Shard, and I'm gonna be able to knock him out with an EQ. So Mamoswine coming in, getting his obligatory or mandatory kill of the game. Always seems to get one. I mean, he always gets one eventually, but I don't know why, he just always manages to get a kill in one of my battles. So, goes out Talonflame. Obviously, I need to preserve Mamoswine so I can take out the Hawlucha with an Ice Shard. So I do go to my Breloom, it's at 1 HP, it's dead. I'm gonna sack it to a Brave Bird. And obviously that Brave Bird would have killed my my Mamoswine, so obviously that was not ideal. Switch out to Breloom, let it die, best thing I could do. And, well, yeah, I'm pretty sure that's the best thing I could do at least. So, he's gonna go out, or I'm gonna go out into my Donphan again. Donphan, my good counter to Talonflame. As he is just going to withdraw, which makes sense. He already knows I packed the Stone Edge. Makes a questionable play though, goes to Hawlucha. I guess he was kind of banking on the Stone Edge miss. I guess the game didn't want to be that mean to me, so it just allowed me to hit another Stone Edge two in a row, even though I missed two in a row. And that is a very respectable amount, even though it is a neutral move. So, I'm going to be able to take him out from that range of HP with the Ice Shard. Very happy with Donphan as well, despite missing the two Stone Edges. He does a very good job taking out this Hawlucha. I still don't get why he went to Hawlucha though. It wasn't going to do too much to Donphan. Donphan has impeccable defenses. So, I mean, it was going to take a hit regardless. But anyway, goes out to Guja. This thing is a problem. I pretty much need a free switch out to Mamoswine to take it on. So I decide I'm going to sack my Talonflame, which could have helped in the battle, I guess. But I don't know. I just trust Mamoswine a whole lot more to get the job done. So he goes for the Draco Meteor. That's going to straight up destroy my life and ruin my Talonflame. So no input from Talonflame, who usually does a lot of work in battles. But this time it was just pretty much dead fodder on the switch into this Gudra, as I am going to go to Mamoswine and just go for the Ice Crash, as I believe he switches out into his Talonflame, which at the range of HP it's at is not going to appreciate a Life Orb Icicle Crash from Mamoswine. Luckily, I do not miss. That would have been bad, but luckily I hit it, and I am able to knock it out. And Mamoswine pretty much just cleans up the game from this point, as I am able to go for another Icicle Crash on the incoming Gudra and knock it out cleanly from 100% HP. Mamoswine being Mamoswine, just... Oh, I actually go for Earthquake. I think... Oh, yeah, I remember now. I knew Icicle Crash would kill, but I knew Earthquake would as well. I was kind of not risking the miss on the Icicle Crash, as I did have pretty bad luck with Icicle Crash, and, well, not in this match, but in future matches and, or past matches and with Stone Edge. I just didn't want to risk my luck. So, that's pretty much about it, guys. Hopefully you enjoyed it. Be sure to check out Just a Bomb's channel. It'll be linked in the description. He's a nice guy, so go like his videos and whatever, I guess. And that's pretty much it. So, let's thank you guys for watching. If you enjoyed the battle, be sure to leave a like. Make sure to leave a lot of love for Mamoswine. He's just done so much. And I'll see you guys for more shortly enough. Catch you guys then.